In this video, I'll show you how to cut and slice text in After Effects. Let's get to it. Here we are in After Effects, and to begin, I'm going to create a new 1920 by 1080 composition at 30 frames per second. Click OK. Then select the Type tool, click and type something. You can see all of my text settings over here. I'm using Montserrat font. After typing the text, I'm going to switch to the selection tool, make the text slightly bigger, then open the Align tab and align it horizontally and vertically so it is at the center of the composition. After aligning the text, let's right-click on the text layer, select Pre-compose, don't name it anything yet, just click OK. Now let's enable Title Action Save from here so that we can see the exact middle of the composition. Then in the Tools bar, select the Rectangle tool, make sure the text pre-comp is selected, and now we're going to create a rectangular mask covering the top half of the composition. So click a point, drag it across, and make sure you bring it to the exact middle. And make sure the mask is covering all of the edges of the composition. Now I'm going to switch back to the selection tool. I'm going to select the pre-comp that we have, go up to edit, duplicate, or press Ctrl D is the shortcut. Now we have two and we can rename them accordingly. I'm going to name this one top because it will be at the top, and this one will be at the bottom. So rename it to bottom. And now for the bottom layer in the mask one, let's check inverted box. And now we can see the text. And if you click away and zoom in, and in case if you see a line going across, you can fix it by opening the bottom layer's mask properties and set mask expansion to -1 pixel. In my case, I'm not gonna because I'm not getting that issue, but if you do, keep that in mind. Now at this point, let's select both layers and press P on the keyboard to open position. And I'm going to create a first keyframe for position at default values at the start of the timeline. Then go half a second forward, that will be 15 frames for me. And here you can reposition both halves to your liking, but I want to have a symmetrical movement. For this, I'm going to add 20 pixels to the X, just double click and then add a plus 20 at the end, that moves it to the right. And then I'm going to subtract 10 from the Y, so -10, and that puts it up. And I'm going to do exactly the opposite for the bottom layer. So double click and then -20. And then for this one, I'm going to add a 10, and this puts it to the bottom left. And that gives us this simple animation, and we're not going to adjust the velocity of the keyframes just yet because we still need to add drop shadow. Now for the drop shadow, let's open effects and presets, search for drop shadow, and add it to the top layer. Then in Effect Controls panel, increase the softness to 100 or 200, I'm going for 200. Then increase the distance to your liking. Also adjust the direction or the angle of the drop shadow. Now let's go to the first keyframe for position that we created for the pre-comps and create a keyframe for opacity of the drop shadow and set it to 0%. Then go to the second position keyframe for those layers and increase the opacity of the drop shadow to 100 or less, depends how much of a drop shadow you want to have. I'm going for 100%. And now if you select both layers again and press U on a keyboard to see all of the keyframes, then drag and select all of them, right click any of them, keyframe assistant easy, so you can press F9 as the shortcut. Now all the keyframes are selected, let's open graph editor. And if your graph looks different, right-click and make sure Edit Speed Graph is selected. Then I'm going to drag and select all of the keyframes here until we see the yellow handles. And I'm going to drag both yellow handles all the way to the left to create this kind of graph. And then exit the graph editor, and this will give us a very quick animation at the start. So that's how we are slicing the text. And we can add a really cool thing to this by adding an adjustment layer. So if we go up to a layer, new adjustment layer, make sure it is above both text layers. Then in Effects and Presets, search for Transform. Add it to the adjustment layer, and now in Effect Controls, I'm going to set skew to -10, and that skews everything and in my opinion makes it look a lot better. So now if we do the preview, this is how we're slicing the text in half. And the coolest thing about this animation is that if we want to change the text, all we have to do is open any of these pre-comp, let's go for the top, and change the text in here for something else, let's go for cut, and then go back to the main composition. Now we have a different word with the same effect. So you can easily swap them out in case if you need to. So that is one way of cutting the text or slicing the text in half in After Effects. Thank you guys for watching.